Let's talk about conversational agents and how you can orchestrate foundation models to solve tasks related to your business. Hello, I'm Seb. Welcome to the third and last part of this mini-series. I use the analogy of Paul. Paul is my super smart assistant. Paul has been trained on everything that can be read on the internet. He has an immense memory of 80 billion token. He's very good at writing, summarizing, or classifying text, but he doesn't know a clue about my business. I want Paul to help my customer to answer a question about our products. In the first video, I talk about continue pre-training and fine-tuning. In the second video, I explain the concept of RAG, where Paul works with Victor, my librarian, to search relevant documents that might be pertinent to answer a question and provide Paul with these documents together with the question I'm asking. What if, instead of searching for existing documents in a library, a vector database, we can call arbitrary code or API to retrieve or change information? This is the last technique I want to share with you, agent. The agent is a piece of code that has a set of tools like API or function. It will use the foundation model to select the best tool to answer a question. It will also ask the model to find a match with the parameters of the API it can use. Once the API and its parameter are identified, the agent calls the API and gives the answer of the API to the model to let him formulate a response. Let's see a practical example. Imagine I want my large language model to answer a question about the stock exchange and the price of a specific stock. I have an API able to retrieve the price of a stock right now in real time. So I ask, what is the price of Amazon? The agent is first going to interact with the model to say, hey, given the API that I have here at my disposal, the set of tools that I have, is there one I can use to answer the question I receive? And Paul will look at all the tool, all the question that I submit, and he will most probably answer something like, yes, you can use the stock API. Based on that information, the agent will call the stock price API, give whatever parameter as an input, wait for the answer, and give the answer together with the original question to the large language model. And Paul, or my large language model, will do what he can do best to formulate a response based on all these information, saying, hey, the value of AMZN today is 169 dot something US dollar. So let's see how you can create an agent inside the console. I open the Amazon Bedrock console and I go to the agent section of the console. I click the orange button, give my agent a name, a description, and a couple of instructions that tells the system what the agent is able to do. I also select the base large language model, foundation model I want to use in this context. On the next screen, I select my tools. So I select a Lambda function that I have already written that is available, and I define the input and output parameters of that Lambda function using an Open API document. When everything is correctly configured, the Bedrock console gives me a playground, a chat, where I can test the interaction with my agent. But there is another way than the Bedrock console to create agents. You can also programmatically write your own agent using the new Bedrock Converse API that we launched in June 2024. So let me show you how it works. I take my hat of a Python developer, and I will write specific code that will coordinate the interaction with the large language model. So first, I define a data structure that lists all the tools that I have at my disposal. In this case, I'm telling the system, hey, I have that stock quote API, and this is the description of the input parameter of the API. So when a user uses the agent asking, what is the price of Amazon today? The code I wrote, the agent, is actually transform that question into a JSON document and give that JSON document together with the list of the tools that I have to a large language model. And the answer from this model, the answer to the agent, not the answer to the user, the answer to the agent is, to answer that question, please use the stock API tool, and this is the parameter to give to the Stock API tool. And look, the first thing there, the question was about the price of Amazon, but the model understood that the stock quote is actually AMZN. So he made a first understanding of the question and was able to map the question to actual parameter to give to the tools. Now that the agent, my code, has that information, the agent calls the API, wait for the answer from the API, and in a last interaction with the large language model, the agent, the code I wrote, is going to give the answer it received from the API to the large language model. Notice at the second section of the JSON there is the raw copy-paste of the JSON that I received from the API. And based on that information, the model will generate an answer and will tell me the current price of Amazon AMZN stock is blah, 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 blah. My API is not a real one. It generates random price. So if you own some Amazon stock, don't be worried. I hope this series of video was useful. Please share them and give us some feedback. And now, go build with Amazon Bedrock.